all the standards. They're fun to watch. They're really frustrating to get hit with. It's going to be a phenomenal set. We are immediately in its winner's semis. Hotline takes the first assault with a quick... Like, one thing that Yoshi is so great at is shield pressure. And once he really gets you into a combo, you are just at risk. His forward air is just going to send you straight to the ground once you're off stage. Really, like... Let's see. Good approach from Fire Blaster there. He's been able to manage himself a little bit better this stock. And a good trade to allow, not even to reset into neutral, but to allow Fire Blaster to really gain advantage again. And forward air into down smash was all he really needed to grab ledge, but Fire Blaster gets back. He's still safe. And the up smash takes Hotline's first stock. Now, what I used to find myself doing whenever I had found myself in a situation where my opponent had invincibility, I would find myself going off stage, which put me at disadvantage. Fire Blaster did the same there, but it turned out well for him. Is he really, rather than just jumping off and having to recover immediately, he went for ledge, which was a good option. Now, one thing that Fire Blaster is amazing at doing, if you've been watching the rest of the tournament, he's so good at fireball placement. He uses them not as a way to really approach, but as a way of just, like, kind of cordoning off parts of the stage and making do-not-enter zones for Hotline or whoever he's really facing. And I would say that he's going to have to do a lot more of that if he wants to take this game. And even the set in general, if he's going to keep doing Mario. Like, one thing that we know is that Fire Blaster has a wide assortment of characters, any of which he could go to. And the forward air really ended it for him game one. I'm 75% sure this one is best of five. Oh, it's best of three. I was mistaken. Ah. So yeah, Hotline isn't switching, and Fire Blaster is going to Captain Falcon. Oh, this should be... Like, Fire Blaster's Falcon is solid. Definitely the character that I feel like, of all the people that he's been really working into his play since around the fall, Falcon is the one that I would say is the most consistent of the three. Ooh. But one of the problems with weightier characters is that they really are at the mercy of Yoshi's up air whenever it wants to just hit them with the first hit of it and safely fall back to stage. He can just combo it back into itself, like, ad infinitum. It allows Hotline to extend combos far longer than he should be able to, then just end things quickly and take advantage of the high percents. Oh, that's gonna be it for Fire Blaster's second stock. Hotline, it was well, but he's got a commanding lead right now. Ooh, up B could, no, that resets the double jump, but the Falcon Punch there. That was some fun play from Fire Blaster that did indeed have the opportunity to end things for him. That was such a interesting neutral where both of them were not necessarily afraid to approach, but they knew that there was a very good chance of getting punished if they did. They really played it safely, rather than really risking something with too hardened aggression. Oh. Good forward smash from Fire Blaster. And I liked what he was going for with the dash attack, but I'm not sure if it was a bit too early or a bit too late to take advantage of the double jump armor. Falcon Punch again. Led to Fire Blaster getting caught in the egg, but he was able to get out and return to a safe position. He's still at a slight disadvantage because he's got one stock to two, but he's been moving really far forward. Down air takes it. Good lord, Fire Blaster, that was crispy. So, we are back in a situation where it was anybody's game. We're gonna have to see. Hotline could be getting a little bit caught off guard, is he's in another strong combo. Up B, puts him back off ledge. Down air, forward throw, up air. The Captain Falcon standard sends Hotline skyward. He's got a rush to keep himself on the ground. Down at B as a last ditch effort. But Fire Blaster knew exactly that was coming. Back air clears out the game. We are going into game three. Amazing play. Phenomenal play. Godly play. Just, there are so many adjectives I could use to describe that play. All of them are synonymous with fantastic. Phenomenal, even. Oh, I am parched. And for game three. And for game three, I think we're going to see a little bit more of the same. And of course, we want to see more of the same, because that was so good. Produce, are you here to join me? No, you are not. You are going to do some PM thread. That happens. More solo commentary for me. This is fun. I'm into it now. Let's go. Oh, they're getting a moment to get themselves hydrated. You gotta stay safe out here. It's a cruel wasteland of Super Smash Brothers from Nintendo 64. We are back involved. Hotline knows that he is going to have to be a little bit more aggressive if he wants to still win. But Fire Blaster is immediately broken shield, and it has led such a quick combo. Once again, trying to use the Falcon Punch as an edgeguarding tool against Yoshi. But this time, Hotline saw it coming and was able to DI out of it, out of the way. Oop, back air, he tried again with comboing it into back air, but this time, up B and onto shield was really all Fire Blaster needed. That grab box is immense. Great timing on the up B there for Fire Blaster. Like, if he had done it a little bit earlier, or a little bit later, Hotline would have caught him with the forward air, and it would have led to him losing his first stock. But Fire Blaster has just entered an entirely new world halfway through game two, and he is really taking control. He knows that he is in the middle of the battle for Winner's Finals, and he wants to be in Winner's side as long as he can. Oh. Once again, Hotline really taking advantage of, like, the first, the earlier, kind of weaker hitbox of the up air as a comboing tool. And we are back in a situation where both of them are pretty even at exactly the same percent at two stocks. Once again, using that light hit on the up air to combo Fire Blaster into a percent where he could just take advantage and kill him is like clockwork, really. Oh, forward smash was, I don't want to say a whiff, but maybe it was a, like, risk. Tried to go for a read, maybe. And, aw. Tried with the up B, but he was a bit too far out. Great play from both. Good stuff. Oh, those were... Oh, that combo was a good one right there. Oh, the up airs. The up airs, I love them. They hurt me, but I love them. Up smash clears it. Amazing.